Years Later is a series where I take a look back on past pop culture and cinema and see if films that are 10 or more years older still hold up. Today's episode will be on Cowboys and Aliens. It was released on July 29th, 2011. So, does it hold up?
What year is it?
Whoa, what?
Thursday.
What year?
No, what?
So this is an interesting sort of movie because I like the cast. The reason why I even looked it up or know about it, I did research on what episode to do on Years Later. Popped up, it had Daniel Craig, Harrison Ford on the poster. So I was like, okay, let me look up the other cast. Olivia Wilde, that one guy from, not Django, what's the Hateful Eight, that one guy with Samuel Jackson near the end. Cast in this movie is pretty damn good. So I was like, okay, interesting. And just doing more research on it because I've never heard of this movie before upon researching. And it flopped, which kind of shocked me because this is a fun movie. This is a fun, entertaining movie blending in the alien kind of genre and then the western cowboy genre, blend them together, and I think it works. Now there is some meandering parts here and there, but as a film it works, and it was directed by Jon Favreau. All these names and people behind it, I don't know why this wasn't successful. Maybe again, 2011, that was the year of, I don't know, Green Lantern, Captain America, I don't know, I forgot. But like, I don't know why this was a flop. Fun movie. It starts off like an Amnesia kind of vibe, which isn't the best, I won't lie. Whenever there's a story or book or any form of media that starts you off the movie in some sort of like amnesia type of character, most of the time I don't like that because it's just kind of boring. Movie kind of goes that route where Daniel Craig wakes up, he's the guy who has no memory of himself. Apparently he had a wife and everything, and he has his armrest thing, which turns out to be alien technology. But after a while in the movie, I think near like the halfway point or the start of the second half, it got kind of boring. I was like, okay, this character, he's a badass, right? He's unknown, this town doesn't know him, they want to put him in jail, stranger, apparently there's like a bounty on him. And then throughout the film we get through flashbacks and find out more about him. At a certain point I didn't care. I was like, okay, can you know, just be the badass guy. I don't need to know your backstory. Just be that cool dude that kills these aliens, helps out this town. That's all I wanted. And while I got that, it really wanted to flash back to his back, which I personally did not care for at all. And then the rest of the characters are fine. Like, there are definitely standout characters, like the son of Harrison Ford. He's an asshole, but I want to watch him just kind of break the law and do everything because he is the son of this town. Son of the town. That doesn't make any sense. He's the son of Harrison Ford, who is like running the whole town. Even the sheriff can do anything about it. He's like bullying people until Craig shows up and just not puts him down but shows him he's badass. Olivia Wilde, or it's a Wilde, right? That's her name, Wilde, I think it is. She's kind of a cool character. She's a character that makes the ultimate sacrifice near the end, but she's kind of that weird like character who's fixated on Daniel Craig for some weird reason. She just is. It's like, okay, but she makes the ultimate sacrifice as well. So it's like, but then the issue with that is I don't feel any emotional weight. When I heard of this movie Cowboys and Aliens, it really should have just been about just a lot of fun, ridiculous stuff. And so when you have these serious moments, I don't really care nor buy because I want it to be this kind of ridiculous kind of movie. That's not what I got right now, what Robert wanted to go with. But I don't know, Cowboys and Aliens, when I hear that, I hear just comedy gold and ridiculous stuff. Craig watch wrist thing is cool. Like, it's blending again, it looks cool because it is in a western style kind of movie. So when you have all these alien tech come in, it's like, it's weird but cool. That's kind of my reaction to everything in this movie. That's weird but that's cool. And then what's also cool are the aliens themselves. They look creepy and cool, and they are slightly bigger. That's the whole scare factor, but they look good just in terms of like design and how they look. And it's also because of these aliens that there's like this watch wrist on Craig. They apparently experimented on him and a ton of other people. That's what they're here for. These aliens are big, scary, and I heard experiment. And by the end of the sacrifice made by Olivia, there's a big explosion. But getting there, while fun, it did feel meandering. Like, there's a lot of camping and talking, which isn't an issue, but it's like, I don't know, like, this movie was a bit too long. The runtime was 2 hours and 15 minutes. Honestly should have been like a 90 minute film. It is like, I don't know, I'm not too fond of the western genre. I don't really like the genre at all, so I don't really care for it as well. So when you have that, make me care about it with the alien stuff and tech, and it does. And so that first like alien spaceship that arrives, that's probably the height of the movie to me. It's a really cool moment, the whole town and Craig realizing, hey, there's something else beyond humans and humanity. There are these weird looking aliens and it's cool. And the journey to getting there and how to defeat all of them was fine, it was good. But I just wish it was more, it leaned more into like just kind of the ridiculous aspect to it. Just westerns and aliens mesh kind of well together, at least to me. On paper it doesn't, but when it is executed correctly like this movie, and it does, it's a lot of fun to watch. So while I like Daniel Craig in this movie, he is bland. He's the badass character that just does everything kind of correctly in a way, and then it has to be saved, there's a sacrifice made, and he goes back to his house, wife. To be honest, I completely forgot about the whole family aspect of it, of his wife. I don't know where that went, because I forgot. I just kind of checked out. I was like, don't really care for this. But either way, they stop the alien invasion from experimenting and just invading on Earth. And then I guess in the epilogue, dog, everyone's happy. The son isn't an asshole no more, which sucks. I wanted to be an asshole, just a complete dick. It was a lot of fun to watch, just kind of seeing him break the law, do whatever he wants. Harrison Ford respects Daniel Craig now. He's all, you know, walking off on his horse. The town's being remade. There's kind of the, I guess, the start of like revolutionizing like how things work and how to live, essentially how it starts. That was cool, but aside from that, that's pretty much it. That's all I have to say about this movie. Clearly I liked it, but I wish it was just much more than just like a serious tone movie. I wish it was way more, a bit wackier, a bit maybe ridiculous. Our main character Daniel, while he's a badass, he's a bit boring in the second half. He's just, okay, he's just badass character that's a bit bland. And the same goes for the rest of the characters. While I like them, I didn't really gravitate, nor did I fall in love with them. They were just kind of there. So in the end, Cowboys and Aliens 10 years later still holds up. It is still a fun and good movie, but that's pretty much it. That's all that really there. It's just a really fun ride, and if you're there for that, then this is gonna be a fun watch. So that's it for me. This has been The Road So Far. Thank you for watching.